Veterinary medicine has a recorded history stretching back to around 1770 BC Mesopotamia in the Code of Hammurabi, circa 2600 BC in both China's Classic Mountains and Seas and Egypt's Kahun Papyrus, and in other cultures across the globe, possibly as far back as 9000 BC. However, it took until Wilhelm Conrad Röntgen's discovery of X-rays in 1895 AD for us to be able to non-invasively view injuries within our animal patients. It only took 1 year later for veterinary radiology to appear in the papers. In 1896, Joseph Maria Eder and Edward Valenta released Experiments in Photography by Means of X-rays, with 15 images of radiographs now in the public domain. These X-rays were 1,500 times more radioactive than comparable modern equipment. Years later, in 1905 and 1906, papers were presented on veterinary X-ray therapy, a practice used to kill cancer cells and shrink tumors, but cautioned about the destructive effects of the X-ray. All the way through the 1950s, vet techs who tested the machines were often seen as replaceable. 1926, Dr. Paul Henkel's Veterinary Radiology created one of the first official journalistic texts of that name. While the illustrations from radiograph data were widely informative, the diagnoses themselves were not quite there yet. In 1937, all the way to 1947, the North American veterinarian in Chicago started a series of bi-monthly articles on diagnostic radiology. New diagnoses for hip dysplasia, leg Perthes disease, invertebral disc disease, and tumors in canine nares were discovered. Then, in 1938, the University of Pennsylvania installed its first X-ray therapeutic apparatus, which then spread across the U.S. and other veterinary colleges. However, using X-rays for diagnosing animal patients lagged far behind humans. Veterinarians focused their energy on helping farmers with their livestock, seeing little financial investments. World War II produced the greatest interest in veterinary radiology, as the creation of the atomic bomb brought radiation into the public knowledge, and thus the million-dollar funding poured in, along with the bountiful safety regulations on X-ray equipment.
Be sure and remember what Bert the Turtle just did, friends, because every one of us must remember to do the same thing.
The Journal of the Veterinary Radiology Association would come into being in 1962, partly because other journals refused to reproduce radiographs of adequate size and quality to be useful. The same year, the American Board of Veterinary Radiology arrived, born out of a home in Elkhart, Indiana, and it began providing radiology education and training across the nation. The first computerized tomography, or CT scans, arrived in the 1960s, partially attributed to the success of the Beatles. Abbey Road Studios would use their sales to help fund the research that allowed for the CT scanner's creation. This could produce a series of X-ray images from different angles to create cross sections of a patient. The first commercially available CT scanner in 1962 would later provide Godfrey Hunsfield and Dr. Alan Cormack the Nobel Prize in Physiology and Medicine. Similar to using X-ray diagnostics, when the first CT scans were used on humans, it would take another decade to enter the realm of animal medicine. Our current achievements in radiology originated in part from the great work of small farmside veterinarians. X-rays allow us to non-invasively examine wildlife for injuries and disease so that our veterinarians can diagnose a problem as quickly as possible. In the modern day, we have made vast innovations in radiology tech. X-ray devices are only opened for a few milliseconds, in contrast to the initial 30 minutes when X-rays were discovered, practically eliminating the risk of direct radiation damage. We still leave the room when taking an X-ray of a patient, which will usually be under anesthesia. If we cannot anesthetize a patient, we will use lead aprons, lead gloves, and thyroid shields for personal protection. These dosimetry badges measure any radiation exposure present in the room, and we send it off to a company to confirm we don't have any issues. With a computed radiography scanner, we don't even have to process the film ourselves, as it automatically sends the X-ray image to our digital databases. To celebrate this history near the International Day of Veterinary Medicine, the Wildlife Center of Virginia is entering 15 sets of its radiographs into the Creative Commons for educational purposes. look at the description below and check them out. Whether it's an Eastern screech owl with a fractured femur, a rat snake who ate a fake egg, or a great blue heron who ran into barbed wire, we are able to treat thousands of animals every year.